Mars.
So we're back with the cricket, 51 for 4, 12 overs gone.
Okay, now job.
So Lechaina, welcome back Mark for the resumption as we see a single taken here from
Prasad. So Prasad just have to start again, you know, after a water break, sometimes you tend to lose your concentration, so you just have to start both batsmen, play again, start to play ball and merit and play ball with caution.
So a partnership of 32, it's been a big one so far of 45 balls, very important one here for the pair. Robin Ruplal, the man on strike, gets a good delivery from Matthew Lechaina.
Yes, that was right up in the block wall, good bowling in this format of cricket.
So the Guyana on the 25 team being handled by Avi Tanpal and Sharma Sukhdeo. Manager and coach, and the rest of the Caribbean, of course, handled by Amarnath Prasad and Mark O'Dean. See your name on the list, Mark.
Oh, good delivery. So this is much better over by Matthew Lechaina. Getting a bye there. So he's mixing up his deliveries and he's bowling a fuller length. First over, he's bowling a bit too short. So this time he's going to come around the wicket to bowl to Mahendra Prasad in the field. Backward square, man of the cow corner boundary, short mid on, or short mid wicket, man long on boundary. Good delivery, but ill directed. Somewhat the line of leg stump, the batsman. Hustle two runs.
Yeah, good turning in to the onside by Mahendra Prasad. He has gone up to 20 and the partnership has gone up to 35. Very important runs.
Yes, good batting so far by Mahendra Prasad. Using his experience so far. As I say, he's an informed batsman all season, so he should be capitalizing. Oh, that's a good shot. Four runs, a short delivery, and batsman is in the wicket, and a pull shot had a lot of elevation, but no distance, and the ball dropped one bounce and went into the boundary for 4 runs.
So 13 overs gone, 59 for 4, Mahendra Prasad on 24, Robin Ruplal is on 12, and so it's 59 for 4, Mark. Good recovery, a 39-run partnership, and they're going at 4.5 runs and over.
Yes, both batsmen playing lovely. As I told you before, this is the partnership. Just from my observation, both batsmen looks good quality players and knows about their work, goes on about their work in a good way as well. So it's a new over going to be start by Balobi. Oh, okay, it's spelling is wrong there. Oh, okay, all right. Balgobin from the far end, tossed up. Good delivery, just about the off stump and moving away with the leg spin. Well collected by the keeper. Amir Singh doing a good job standing up. A little bit full, dripping down to deep long off. Hoyt runs a picks up, feels, and throws the ball into Balgobin. So I'm impressed with Balgobin. Good little leg spinner.
Yes, Mark, he comes out of MMZ. You don't see too much spinners bowling with loop and flight these days because certainly of T20 cricket, everyone seems to be darting the ball in. Good flight and good turn on the ball. Being a wrist spinner, he does get the ball to bounce and turn.
Yes, but in this form of cricket, the slower ball is the harder to hit. So, you know, once a bowler back himself and could utilize his skills, you know, he'd be successful in this format of the game.
So the partnership goes into the 41 run partnership, comes into Ruplal. Ruplal gets a ball, sort of like a low full toss, doesn't do much with it.
Yeah, because he played across the line. If he had driven it straight, then he could have capitalized on that delivery.
Play the miss again. We'll have to wait and see. Is that a stumping or
yes,
has it been bowled?
Brilliantly stumped by Singh standing up. He went down the pitch, tossed up, hit in the air, played all over it, and Robin Ruplal missed it completely. His inning come to an end. Stump Amir Singh, bowl Babubin for 13. But he put up a good resistance with Mahendra Prasad, put some respectable total. For the Ghana team so far. So Ghana 61 for 5, 67 balls to come. Mahendra Prasad is still there in 25. The new batsman is Kelvin Shuprasad. And again, he's in good form, MMZ player. So let's see if he could occupy the crease and with Mahendra Prasad and put up a good partnership.
So the partnership of 41 comes to an end. Balgobin has picked up his first wicket. Kelvin has come to the middle. They're batting a 61 for 5, 67 balls to go. We're playing at 25 overs a side here.
So 60 balls, 67 balls to come, so that could be at least 100 runs. So I'm looking at 161 by the Ghana under 25 team. Once we have a good partnership by Shuprasad, that was a good shot by Shuprasad outside the off stump and lead cut down back with a point and Hamza Rana runs and picks up and in the meantime the batsman comes to 2 runs. Shuprasad is off the mark. Ends the over. So the latest score here is 63 for 5.
So 14 over, 63 for 5. Mahendra Prasad on 25 will be the man on strike when play resumes here in the 31st annual ICF Trophy game. We've got the seniors playing a little bit later on. So 63 for 5, Mahendra Prasad is on 25. Kelvin Shuprasad is on 2. And we've seen 14 overs so far.
Okay, so far 63 for 5. So new bowler, she looks like Hamza is going to come back to the attack. Is that? Yeah, Hamza Rana. Yeah, Hamza is back into the attack.
So Rana, 4 overs, 2 made, 2 for 5. Impressive bowling figures.
Stop.
You're long, brother.
Oh, that's it. 6 runs, tossed up, and Mahendra Prasad went for the big hit. Fielder came around the boundary, but just got a hand to it and knocked it over the boundary in the process. And 6 runs there for Mahendra Prasad. The total goes up to 69.
Yeah, good strike here from Mahendra Prasad. Prasad has now struck 4 boundaries, 1, 6, and 3, 4s. Mahendra Prasad, sorry. Not to be confused with Mahendra Parsram, couple of Mahendra
yes.
in the lineup.
Yeah.
He's on 31, he hammers this one through the offside. Could get him a couple of runs at least. Fielder comes around, picks up cleanly, but only a single on this occasion. Good looking shot through the offside again.
Yes, off the back foot, and he just hammered it nicely, all on the ground as well. That was an elegant shot.
So we've got 64 balls remaining. Kelvin comes into strike. Kelvin is another player comes out of MMZ. And the fact is, Mark, a lot of these under 25 players, they're playing senior cricket in the New York City area.
Yeah, some of them start at a young age, so they're quite accomplished.
So doesn't time it well, Kelvin, not really to the pitch of the ball. And he gets a single out towards the offside brings the Croatia down to 63 balls remaining, 7-1 on the board. They're batting a 7-1 for 5. We are in over number 15.
And that was a slow delivery, and Pisada's off the back foot, had to wait on it. Good variation there by Hamza.
So Mahendra Prasad is at 32 off 29 balls. That's a good quality delivery, good take from Amir Singh.
Yeah, and that was a quicker delivery as well. Got some drift in that delivery. So basically beat him for pace.
So Amir Singh, we've seen him with a couple of dismissals. He's been tidy so far. Ball turned into the onside. Can score is Mahendra Prasad. And so that completes over number 15, 71 for 5.
Yes, that is a decent over besides the boundary, that 6, that maximum from Prasad. Decent over by Hamza. Mixing it up, I think that's the end of his spell. 5 overs, 2 maidens, 13 runs, 2 wickets. Excellent bowling today by Hamza Rana, the off spinner from Brooklyn. So it's going to be Kelvin Shuprasad. Season 3, and Balgobin is going to be coming in from the airport end.
Yeah, let's look at what Balgobin has done. 2 of his numbing, 1 for 8. He's been tidy, he's picked up 1.
Yes, for leg spinner, that's good figures because you know it's a different kind of skill. Bowling from back of the arm, the wrist. Need a lot of control and confidence as a leg spinner.
So Kelvin, we've seen him from time to time, Mark. He can give the ball a tap. Not that you need the aggression now, but just making the point.
Yes.
You still have 60 balls, a long way to go.
Yeah, saw him batted for MMZ this season. Played a fine hand, one match. I think he got 30 on.
So Balgobin to Prasad and Shuprasad. Shuprasad gets a quality delivery, a clear and a miss. So the ball goes through to Amir Singh.
Yeah, that's a nice, good leg break, tossed up. Good spin. He's getting the ball to bounce and spin.
Yeah, good flight. Making the point, not too often you see bowlers brave enough to bowl with so much flight in limited overs cricket, let alone T20 or 25 over. This one heading Dangal XI, called a while from Mangesh Rani. I thought that the batsman should have done a little bit more with that, Mark. Ball yeah. Heading down the left side, give it a good whack.
Yeah, I think he tried to hit it too hard and in the process missed it completely.
So Shuprasad remains on 3 off 3 balls, gets the ball, hammers into the offside. Ball beating the field. Single to Shuprasad brings hands the strike over to Mahendra Prasad. Mahendra has batted well, Mark. 32 for 31, 73 for 5.
Yes, busy innings so far. As I say, looks a good player. Looks like he's hungry for scoring runs. Our Phoenix Cricket Club captain. Wow, that's a good shot. He picked it up from outside the line of the off stump and went over deep. Mid-wicket, 6 runs, magnificent shot there by Mahendra Prasad.
Yeah, Mahendra Prasad has picked up his second maximum of the day, 2 maximum and 3 fours. And he goes up to 38, he's looked the part, the captain of Phoenix.
Yes, very impressive so far. I'm very happy and impressed with what I see so far from Mahendra Prasad. I mean, I've been reading about him every week, but like I told Sharma, I want to see him better, and what I see today, man, it's very classy. He could hit the ball on the ground, gives it a good tap as well, and he plays on merit, so he has some good traits as a batsman.
It's a good bit of timing there. Timing takes the ball far, Mark. Six is a long distance shot.
Yeah, but again, the bats today are so good, you know, so you just gotta get it halfway in the middle, and it goes a distance.
Combination of a bat swing or a bat speed, combination of the chunk of wood, and also has to do a lot with timing. Good looking shot from Mahendra Prasad, 7-9 for 5. We are in the 16th.
He's in 38. Balgobin comes up, off the back of the bat, and the batsman's counters for quick single in the process. Good anticipation there by Kelvin Shuprasad, and he's backing up, so he was off the mark in a flash. So one more run to the total, it goes up to 80 for 5. Kelvin Chupa side is in 4. He taps his bat. Toss up. Good shot. Just sticks it out. Goes to the sweep on the deep cover point boundary. And in the meantime, the batsman just scores for 2 runs. Good cricket there by Shipasad.
Yeah, good cricket. We've seen good running. We've seen good support from the Guyana U25 as Mahendra Prasad wants a drink. 82 for 5. We're in the 16.
And that was a good shot again by Prasad off the back foot this time, hitting it into the ground. And it goes down to Hoyt and the long off boundary. And meantime, the batsman across for 1 ends the over. So under 25, Guyana under 25, 83 for 5. Mahendra Prasad 39, Shipasad and 7. Busy players so far. So hopefully we could get some good action. There's about 54 deliveries to come. So looking at these at 160, if the 2 batsmen remain.
So the Indo-Caribbean 31st annual cricket match dedicated to the memory of Ronald Chinsami, who has been with the Federation for some 25 years, and Nathan Henderson, who's been around for about five years or so. And Mark, the Nathan Henderson, we've got some other Hendersons on the ground. We've got Seven Perry, who has been around with the ICF for some years, and the baton, the mantle of the leadership or the work will have to be passed on. And Selwyn Perry, a very good man. He's been around the Federation for some time, and he does. And I got to tell you, Selwyn Perry has done tremendous work with this Federation over the years. And when I came to the ground today, he was my lone helper, and he does a tremendous job. So Selwyn Perry, I want to say thank you on behalf of the ICF. So Alex Hussain comes into the attack. Starts with a single, 84 for 5, Mark?
Yes, Sam. So 84 for 5 brings Prasad into strike. Tossed up on drive, down to the man, long on boundary, comes off the boundary. Picks up, throws it in, and one bounce to the bowler, 2 bounces to the bowler. So Alex Hussain, second off spinner, is coming from the commentator boot end, shows the ball from hand to hand. Toss up, and that driven down to long off, and well stopped by Hamza. And one more run to the total, goes up to 86 for 5. Shipasad goes up to 9, Mahendra Prasad back in the strike is on 40.
So the umpires for the game is umpire Danny Khan, president of the United States Cricket Umpires Association. This one is driven well, could be looking for a couple of runs, and they settle for 1. So the umpires Mark are Danny Khan, and Danny Khan has made several years into the ICF. I think this is his 4th year, so he's getting there, and I'll tell you but an umpire's been on the Federation for the longest time, but let's complete the umpire here. So we've seen Danny Khan, the man leading now, and then at square leg, we've got a man from Boston, Mangesh Irani. And always we've seen in the past, umpires from out of state making the rounds, Vijay Malela, who lives now in North Carolina, has always been here over time. And so 17 overs gone, 88 for 5, but just to round off from the umpiring perspective, Steve Kalu, your good friend Steve Kalu, yes, has been with the Federation for 25 years, Mark, consistently, along with Ashok Bridge Kumar from Canada. Wow. He used to always make this trip for 25 years.
Wow.
It was an umpiring pair of Steve Kalu and Ashok Bridge Kumar.
I know Kalu.
And I remember a couple of years ago, the Federation was kind of forced to retire Steve Kalu to give somebody a chance. To rank up 25 years.
Wow. but the umpires in the ICF is always good umpires with high standard and a good ability, you understand? They do a good job year after year. So you're just keeping the standard of bringing a good umpire from out of state. Nice to have the out of state umpire in New York as well.
So Bargobin continues. And this is over number 18 mark. Let's round up some numbers here.
Yeah, so 89-5, the batsman out, Alvin Gangadin 2, Ansar Khan 9, Nicholas Chinko 8, the break. His batsman Prasad just turns it on the on side onto square leg, fielder comes off halfway to the boundary, picks up and it's one more to the total, it's 90-5. So Shah was the next to go for Duck, Mahendra Prasad is batting, he's in 42 not out. And that's a short delivery and it's pulled and the fielder's right on the boundary, takes the catch, a beautiful catch. Shuprasad pulling and the ball sky in a lot of elevation, no distance whatsoever. And well taken by the fielder on the boundary, Alex Hussain. Stayed well composed and that was a very good catch. The total is 90-6 and the precision continues as the new batsman walks in.
Yeah, Mahendra Parsram comes in with Mahendra Prasad. So 90-6, well judged catch from Alex Hussain.
Yes, he was under the ball and he was so calm and cool and composed. And he took it, the Aussie style, right above his face and no chance of dropping that catch. So good wicket there by Balgobin. Balgobin deserve 2 wickets so far. Not bad for a leg spinner. 3 overs, 11 runs and 2 wickets so far. As I say, the leg spinners always play an important role in the shorter format of the game. And a lot of times are very successful.
So the 2 Mahendras out in the middle. Mahendra Prasad, he's batted extremely well. And now joined by Parsram, quality player. So Prasad will be on strike. Balgobin is bowling at 2-22. And that's another quality delivery here from the youngster.
Yeah, good delivery. Mahendra Prasad was forward. He's playing a little bit, should have played with a dead bat. So at least, you know, almost carrying the ball back to the bowler there. Comes up. Tossed up, right outside the off stump. I think it's a no ball called by the umpire. Just hit on the edge of the umpire, the matting, or off the matting a bit there. So no ball called by the umpire. It's going to be a free hit. And Pastram sticking his guard. So probably thanking Jesus. And he's going to go for the fences now. I mean, as a batsman, you get a free hit and you nail it off the mark. You know, you're confident at least of getting off the mark. So he looks around the field. Balgobin. Tossed up. Short delivery. Oh, that was a good release. Bowling, but at least it's a free hit, so it doesn't count. So good comeback so far. Good delivery. Hits a dot ball. So quicker leg break. And it's all through the stroke and take the top of the leg bail. Balgobin. Tossed up right outside the off stump. Batsman lets it go through. Taken by Amir Singh, standing up. It's a wide signal by the umpire. So Balgobin back to the top of his mark. Well played this time by Pastram. Back to the bowler. Ends the over. Total 93-6. Mahendra Prasad is in 42 and Pastram is in naught. So far the bowling figures, Sultan 4 overs. So Sultan 5 overs, 21 runs, 1 wicket. Hamza Rana 5 overs, 2 minutes, 13 runs, 2 wickets. Matty Luchina 2 overs, 16 runs. And Balgobin, 4 overs, 25 runs, 2 wickets. So Alex Hussain is going to be coming into the attack again.
Yeah, Alex has gone first of November 5. Mahendra Prasad will be the man who strike. It is the guy on the 25 best batsman so far. And how do we know he's the best batsman? Well, he scored the most runs so far.
Yes.
He's on 42. He's batted extremely well. Comes forward to a quality delivery here, delivered by Alex Hussain. So we've got 41 balls to be bowled. 93 for 6. This is the 19th. Alex Hussain, who might have played a couple of games of Westbury. This one is struck into the long off area. Fielder comes in. He gets a hand to the ball. Doesn't take the catch. And the ball goes away for 4 mark.
Yeah, that was a bad miss there by Hamza and Bongri. Running in too quickly and just getting a hand to it, his right hand to it, and the ball chipped over the boundary for 4 runs. So Mahendra Prasad living dangerously, but fortune favors the brave. He's at 46 in total, 97 for 6, 18.2 overs ball.
So he's up to 46. Oh, he's that's the 50 to Mahendra Prasad. And a very lucky one for Mahendra Prasad. What should have been a single runs? Akhil Hoyt came around, wasn't able, may have taken his eyes off the ball mark.
Yeah, just a little bad miss by Hoyt. A good feeler. That was a good shot in the process. Hit it straight and in the process he got, brings up his 50. Good batting so far, 101 for 6.
So that not only brings up the 50 for Mahendra Prasad, certainly brought up the 100. Couple of runs there again from Mahendra Prasad. So he continues to forge along. He goes up to 52, it's 103 on the board.
Yes, good batting so far. Good impetus by Prasad. You know, trying to increase the scoring rate now, up the strike rate. It's batting very good so far. So total is 103 for 6.
So lofted into the onside. Ramba Rose comes around, makes a very good save. But a single to Prasad. So they're going at 5.52 mark. 5.5 runs and over.
Yes, 5.52. Not bad going still because, as I said, the innings has been rebuilt so far by Mahendra Prasad. After the under 25, Ghana under 25 was struggling a bit. So good batting so far. 53 not out from 43 balls. 5-4 so far and 2 sixes. Good batting there. Ball tossed up and just playing it late to the man at 4 short leg and no run there.
So 11 runs off that over. 19 gone, it's 104 for 5.
The pass from here to get off the mark is on 0. Mahendra Prasad 53. You have 36 balls to go, six overs to go. So if Mahendra Prasad is still there, I'm going to double the 36 balls to 72 runs. So you could be looking at 176. But you know, it's cricket, anything can happen. So Bal Gobain is coming in with his last over. He's coming in from the airport end. And the fielder for Prasad, you have a backward point, man sweeping in the cover boundary, short extra cover, man long off boundary, or tossed up.
So, could be a couple of buys here.
Yes, cover buys, at least a batsman advance, so I wouldn't, I think it was the right call by the umpire, not calling a no ball for height. So 106 for 6. Good delivery. Top of off stump, moving away with the turn. Good ball there by Bal Gobain. Typical leg break delivery, leg spinner. Toss off and Mahendra swings across the line, goes down to square leg. Fielder comes off the boundary, picks up underarms it to another fielder. Hamza turns to the bowler. So 107 for 6. Prasad is in 54. Pastram yet to get off the mat. This front rate suffice 5.49. Partnership is 17 runs, winning 19.3 over. Ghana under 25, 107 for 6. 33 deliveries to go. And Bahubain is trying to ball from hand to hand. Tossed up. Beautiful shot. Lovely shot. Toss up over extra cover, 4 runs. Very good shot. It was outside the off stump and he gave him some width there. And the batsman freed his arms. Mahendra Prasaram. And the ball went down to the boundary for 4 runs.
Yes, Mark. Good looking shot from Prasaram. Prasaram comes out of Liberty Lions. Would have gotten 100 the last couple of weeks.
Yes,
3 or 4 weeks ago.
Yes, I saw him scoring 100.
So it's 111 for 6. Balgobin continues. Dangle leg side. He may have prevented the ball from going for a wide by making contact onto the ball.
Yes, the ball was close to pull. Bit of misjudgment there by the batsman. Good delivery. Rocked him in the pad. There's a pin for Ebola. He's on LBW. Ball pitched about leg stump and turning away. Going to hit the off stump, a top of off stump. And Mahendra Prasaram doesn't like it at all, but the umpire raises his finger in affirmative as he walked back to the pavilion. Good wicket there by Balgobin, striking again for the Caribbean under 25. His figures so far, 5 overs, no maidens, 30 runs, 3 wickets. He got a wicket at his last delivery of the spell, and good bowling there by Balgobin. And the total is 111, Nelson for 7. Ghana under 25.
Yeah, good bowling here from Balgobin. And so Mark Fredericks, it appears, as the man walking to the middle. Mahendra Prasad still undefeated at 54. And while Mark, there's a break in the action, I want to run through some of our sponsors today. They include Main Street Insurance, Bowler Traveler Tours, Rockaway Group of Companies, Rudy Prasad, Gemtex USA, Laparkan Shipping, Laparkan International Trading, Queens Resource and Advocacy Center, AD1 Tax Preparation, Central Auto Repair and Body Shop, City Bias and Stitching, Upscale Construction, Cricket Zone USA, GT Tents and Party Rentals, Coffee Distributing Corp, MGN Funding, and ACS, American Cricket Society.
Lots of sponsors. I got a congratulations to sponsors for contributing in this event. Always good to see the local businesses support the cricket. Good delivery by Alex Hussain, and the batsman is forward defensive, Mark Fredericks. 111 for 7.
So Mahendra Prasad on strike. Mark Fredericks.
Non-striker, sorry about that. Comes up. Turns it on the onside, good delivery, and no run there. Fielder from mid-wicket picks up and throws to the keeper. So good bowling so far by Hussain.
Yeah, Alex Hussain has bowled 2.2, none for 16. Comes into to Mahendra Prasad. An attempted shot gets the two end of the bat, gets a single, and brings for the first time Mark Fredericks onto strike. It's 112 for 7.
Yeah, so Fredericks, left-handed batsman, is taking his guard from the umpire.
So we've got 27 balls remaining. This is the 21st. Mark Fredericks will get ready to face his first ball, but the highlight of the innings so far, Mark, has been Mahendra Prasad. Look at that, 55 of 49, and he's still not done yet.
Yes, very good batsman. I say, since this morning, I recognize that this lad has some talent and ability, and that's the man who would get Ghana to a good score today. So, Fredericks, left-handed batsman, there's some adjustments to the field. Hussain. Oh, that's a Jaffa, that's a beautiful delivery. But the batsman should be forward, but he was back to a well pitched up delivery and well taken by Amir Singh standing up.
Yeah, this is going to be like a leg spin to Mark Fredericks. Alex Hussain, the off spinner, but Mark Fredericks is correctly forward. Good bowling here from Alex Hussain.
Yes, he's getting into his work now. 2.5 overs, no maidens, 17 runs, 1 wicket. This over has been a good over so far. Tossed up. and Fredericks just jabbing it on the on side, straight to the mat, mid-wicket, ends the over, total 112 for 7, Mahendra Prasad 55, Fredericks North 21 overs, 4 to come, current partnership is 1, run rate 5.33 so far. Hopefully the batsmen could start to up the run rate because we ran out of overs. Try to get the guy on the 25 to respectable total. Maybe 150, 160. At least give them a chance. Runs on the board in these limited overs matches is runs on the board. Scoreboard pressure. So 112 for 7. Prasad is going to be facing Skipper. And he goes for the big one. Tucks it around. Man comes off the deep mid wicket bunker. Picks up field. Overthrows the ball. Well backed up by the fielder. Extra cover.
So Matthew Lechera comes back into the attack. The captain's 113 for 7. We're in over number 22, Mark Fredericks. Mark Fredericks has faced 3 balls. He has had to contend with some very tidy bowling from Alex Hussain. And the captain, Matthew Lechera, will come into ball to Mark Fredericks. He had to get off the mark and get the ball going down the left side, a swing and a miss. Ball taken in the midsection, it's 113 mark.
Yeah, so but Fredericks' job is really just to rotate the strike and get Mahendra Prasad on strike instead of trying to go for the big hits.
But, you pick this one up, you smash this one out into the big bushes.
Well, that's it, it's close. That was a good shot by Fredericks. Ball was tossed up by Matty and swung it over the boundary. That was a beautiful hit too. And made a nice sound on the bat and flew over deep mid wicket for 6 runs.
Well, big strike here from Mark Fredericks, and that's one of the things, Mark, with strike rate. He is up until that point, he has not got off to the. He has not got off mark. But look, with one swing, he gets 6 runs, and all of a sudden, he's doing better than run the ball.
Yes. Wow, we're the app. Very good by this app. Is this a cricket app? Oh, which one? NX? Oh, okay.
Vai, Pedro! Oi, Mark!
So that was a lost ball, so you got a sort of replacement ball there. So third umpire doing his job.
Yeah, new role for Selwyn Perry. He is the functioning as the third umpire. I wonder if they go upstairs. So ball turning to the inside. Should have gotten a single there, Mark. In the end, they finally go through for one.
Yes. It was a little bit misfield there by the fielder, and the batsman taking the opportunity and scamping through for a run brings Mahendra Prasad back into strike. So Prasad is in 56, Fredericks in 7, a total of 120 for 7. Short delivery in off the back foot. Doesn't time it, hits it into the ground. And the skipper Matthew Fields. So 21.5 overs, partnership is 9, the run rate is 5.5 so far. Quicker delivery, and that was a good shot. Pulled in front of square between mid-wicket and mid-on, and one run to Prasad. He goes up at 57. Ends the over, so 22 overs completed. Partnership of 10 so far, run rate 5.50. Total 121 for 7. And with three of us to go, the batsman would really have to get the impetus, get the foot on the gas now.
Yes, Mark. We have seen it certainly at the big top franchise level and certainly at the international level in T20 cricket. The coaches and certainly the managers are hoping that the last three overs go for like 25 or 30 runs.
Yeah, that's at least 30 runs, you know, most from what I've been seeing so far and viewing on TV and following. Last three overs tends to go for 30, 40 runs. But again, as I say, Mahendra Prasad has been there a while, and he's probably seeing the ball as big as a breadfruit right now. So his eyes, you know, he's going to be facing Jonathan. It's going to come in from the commentator booth. And again, with the fast medium bowler, you have, at least you can play through the line, and at least you get the ball to go to the boundary. With the spinner, you have to manufacture the strike.
So Dublin, to Prasad. Prasad gets a good quality delivery, plays and a miss. And Mark, the guy on the 25 team will be quite happy that Mahendra Parsram stays to the end.
Prasad, yeah, we're saying to Prasad, yeah. So 57 from 53 balls, as I say. You just got to keep batting right down to the last over, and you'll get a good total. Oh, that was a good delivery. Oh, that was some heat. Right up into the ribcage, short delivery, and he just fended off, but the ball went down to the deep square leg. The fielder, the wicketkeeper ran and picked that ball up and threw it. In the meantime, the batsman scored. The batsman went for two runs. So Prasad was number 59. So Jonathan has a bit of gas. I mean, you know, excited to see him bowling now, but at that kind of pace.
Good gas there. Short one into the rib cage.
So Jonathan, I think, is from Barbados. That was a good shot. Short outside the off stump, wide really. And the batsman just using one hand really. Uppercut. And it's a good shot by Prasad. It gets four runs to the delivery. Bowler giving the batsman a lot of wide width there, so that's the batsman can free his arms, and Mahendra Prasad capitalizing it. One hand really, it was a spectacular shot. And the ball went down to the boundary for four runs. So he goes up to 63. Total 127 for seven. Jonathan Dougherty. Short, off the edge, expensive over ball, goes over third man, the ball is going down to the boundary and beats him into the boundary for four runs. So four more runs to Mahendra Prasad. 67, good batting here so far. Up in the strike rate, it's now 5.78. The total 131 for seven. And as expected, the last three overs, as I said, we're looking for 30 runs. This over already have 10 runs so far. So 14 balls to come.
Mahendra Prasad charging the bowler. And you'll certainly get a reward for those brave shots, Mark.
Comes up, balls, and he bangs that. Good looking shot. Well stopped by Akhil Hussain on the boundary. Akhil Hoyt, sorry, on the boundary there. And one run brings Mark Fredericks into strike. Prasad goes for 68. Total 132 for 7.
So this over has gone for 11 so far.
Mark
Fredericks, we saw in the previous over, he could hit the ball out of this park with some bit of ease.
Yes, he seems like he hits a long ball as he taps his bat and waits. Sean, he just turns it nice, left the pads, runs in the making, goes on to the man at square leg, and the meantime the batsman crossed for one, brings it to 132 for seven. And 12 balls to go, so another 24 runs, you're looking at 157, hopefully. So Fredericks has an 8, Prasad 68, total 22 overs to go. 22 overs ball, 22 runs partnership, and as I say, 5.78 runs run rate, not bad. So a good recovery from the Ghana under 25 team after we're struggling a bit this morning. 4 early wickets went down.
So let's have a look at the partnership here, Mark. We saw 4-1 between Ruplal and Mahendra Prasad. In fact, Mahendra Prasad has been part of all the partnership. That's how well this man has batted. Robin Ruplal and Prasad would have put on 41 run. Then we saw Kelvin and Mahendra Prasad getting 29. We see this partnership out in the middle, Mark Fredericks and Mahendra Prasad, a 22-run partnership. And we saw Mahendra Parsram with Mahendra Prasad with a 21-run partnership. So essentially, the 4 biggest partnership of this innings has been all featuring Mahendra Prasad. That's how well he's bat.
Yes, as I said earlier in the piece, that if Ghana is going to get a good total, it's going to be this man have to bat deep into the innings. And that's well said. That's what he did. And he's still batting, still have 12 balls, so he still have more work to be done. New ball is coming to the attack. Haider Ali, man from Pakistan, he's throwing the ball from hand to hand.
Yeah, Haider Ali, first over went for 12, and didn't get a second over mark, as probably he would have gone for quite a few at the top of the order. He comes in now to bolt to Fredericks. And Fredericks is driving and driving well. That's a good shot. Getting the well-set man, Mahendra Prasad, back on strike. You want him to face as many balls with 11 balls remaining.
Yes, brilliant batting there by Mark Fredericks. Good rotation of the strike. Good cricket. See, he's thinking is the game.
So it's 134 with 10 balls remaining. Yes. Psychologically, they will want to get to 150. It makes a big difference.
Yes, 150 at the centre board would give the Caribbean boys a run for their money. So, the field, he's setting a predominant offside field. Haider Ali from the far end. And that's a good shot. Well pitch of delivery, but driven down to deep long off. Well field by Akhil Hoyt and chosen to Haider Ali. So one more run to the total. Prasad goes up to 69. Fredrickson 9 comes into strike. So the field for Fredericks on the on side, you have a square legged cow corner mid wicket. Good looking shot. Straight. Good looking shot there by Mark Fredericks. He has a good name, Mark. And he drives it straight down to the crown and gets a single, goes up to 10.
Certainly, Mark is a popular name, not only certainly in the cricket world, but when you look at Fredericks, one name comes to mind, Roy Fredericks out of Guyana.
Yes. That was a good delivery, top of off stump, outside the off stump, and doesn't collect cleanly by the keeper, Amir Singh, standing up. Prasad just swing across the line there, just trying to go for the maximum. So Haider at the top of his mark, fast medium, coming in from the airport end now. Bowls this one, down the leg side, and misses, and ball comes down to long fine leg, and the fielder picks up and overthrows it a bit, but doesn't cut the line. So a bye signal by umpire. And brings Mark Fredericton to strike. So Fredericks on 10, 23.5 overs. Good over so far by Haider Ali. Oh, Mark swings it. 6 runs. It was a slow delivery, but well picked up by Mark Fredrickson. Picked up on it and swung it over deep mid wicket into boundary. It was 143 for 7 from 24 overs. Fredrickson 16, Mahendra Prasad 69.
Yeah, you know, sooner or later, you're going to see a big shot from Mark Fredericks. A big one. And let's see what Mark Fredericks has done so far. He's struck a couple of sixes. And he's on 16 out from 10 balls. 6-9 to Mahendra Prasad. And a 32-run partnership so far, taking them into the final over. It's 143 mark.
Yes, with last over coming up by Jonathan Duglin. Hopefully batsman can capitalize on it and maybe get another 12-15 runs, give a respectable total. As I said, anything over 150 would be a good total on the board there, psychological effect as well. And captain sets the field meticulously, has a man in the cold corner boundary, short mid wickets. It's a predominant offside field, straight long on, and the offside, Mandeep and the long off boundary, short cover, short extra cover, man sweeping in the cover boundary, third man in the boundary, a point. So Dublin runs away from the commentator booth and goes back. Goes and Passat hits it in the air, the field is coming in and he takes the catch. So well caught. It was a pitched up delivery by Jonathan Dublin, and Mohinder Passat didn't get the elevation, but a good hand. Beautiful batting so far. 69 runs. Great knock by the young man as he walks off.
So it's 143 for 8, and it certainly will get a big round of applause when he comes back to the Guyana on the 25 caps. And Mahindra Pasram falls for 69 from 60 balls. And what an innings he's played here as Sharma Sukhdeo trying to get the grand moment. Well played, Mahindra Prasad out for 69 off 61 balls. It's 143 for 8, Mark.
Yes, as I say, hopefully they could get the total to over to 150. Take 4 deliveries to go. 5 deliveries to go. So.
So Puran Harry Chan comes to the middle. Mark Fredericks will be on strike, but of course, during the dismissal of Mahindra Prasad, Mark, but still 5 balls remaining. The big hit of Mark Fredericks on strike.
Yes, so hopefully we could get to that 150 milestone as Jonathan Dugnan begins to move in now from the commentator booth and goes past umpire. Ball is one outside the off stump. Wide signal by umpire. We keep him moving to his left. Stops it. So total 144 for 8. So Jonathan Dublin bowling at good pace. Sharp. Nice shot by Mark Fredericks. Down to mid off, and the batsman turns for 1. Goes 145 for 8.
So that single will certainly benefit the bowling side. They certainly would want to have a bowl at a new man. And not to say, Mark, that a new man is can't hit the ball out of the park. We don't know, but...
But he has to start. That's a thing. So at least the bowler could slow up the run rate or strike rate.
So 4 balls remaining. It's 145. They still require probably another 5 to make it... another one of those milestones. Here is Dublin. Oh, victory! That's a lovely shot from Puran Harry Charan. He picks up a boundary. Very important one at this juncture of the game, Mark. It's 149.
Yes, that ball was badly directed on the leg stump, and he just helped it. Came in and just helped it with the pace of the ball. It hustled down to the deep backward square bound for 4 runs. That was a lovely shot by Puran Harry Charan.
You still want to probably see Mark Fredericks up and strike, but in the meantime, Puran Harry Chan has done nothing wrong.
Yes, he has done his job so far, so, you know, hats off to him.
So 3 balls remaining. Dublin from the come box and overcast conditions. Mark Fredericks watching the action at 22 yards. He's on 17. It's 149. Dublin runs into ball to Harry Charan. Flicked high in the air. Fielder comes to ring. Nourish! Rambo Rose puts it down. And they come back for a couple of runs. So 2 more runs here. Off the bat of Puran Harry Charan. The 150 comes up. It's 151 for 8.
Yes, so at least they have that 151 psychological runs. Pass 150. So good cricket, good batting by Puran Harry Charan, but a bad miss there by Nourish Rambo Rose. Hopefully it wouldn't cost his team too much, but Dublin has an offside field, but he's bowling a bit too leg-side-ish.
So comes into ball to Harry Chan. Struck and struck well. Will get a single at least. Fielder comes in. Only a single. Brings Mark Fredericks back on strike. It's 152 with 1 ball remaining, Mark.
Yes, so good batting so far by Puran Hari Chan. So Mark Fredericks, probably try to see if you can get a maximum of this last delivery here. It's 152 for 8 from 24.5 overs.
So Mark Fredericks, final ball. Dugman runs into Mark Fredericks. He gets a good delivery on the pads. Turns it into the onside. And they'll settle for a single. A single that will close out the innings, Mark. It's 153. 153 for 8 when the innings comes to an end. And they'll need 154 when they come out back. But this is a quick rundown, Mark. You can quickly run through what we've seen here.
Yeah, so Alvin Gangadin, he went for 2. Ansar Khan, 8. Actually, 9. Nicholas Chinko for 8. Moisha, he went for duck. Mahiji Prasad, a brilliant 69. Robin Wooflal, 13. Kelvin Shuprasad, 11. Mahindra Pashram, 4. Mark Fredericks, 18. Puran Harichan, 7. The bowling figures, Haider Ali, 2 overs, 21 runs, no wickets. Economy, 10.50. Michael Sultan, 5 overs, no maiden, 21 runs, 1 wicket. Economy, rate 4.20. Hamza Rana, brilliant spell, 5 overs, 2 maidens, 13 runs, 2 wickets. Economy rate of 2.60. Matthew Lachina, 3 overs, no minutes, 25 runs, no wickets. Economy 8.33. Bal Gobin, 5 overs, no minutes, 30 runs, 3 wickets. Economy 6.00. Alex Hussein, 3 overs, no minutes, 17 runs, no wickets. Economy rate 5.67. And Jonathan Dublin, 2 overs, no minutes, 22 runs, 1 wicket. Economy rate of 11. So, final score, the Ghana under 25, 153 for 8 from 25 overs, a run rate of 6.16. So, for the Caribbean boys to win, they need to 154 runs. This is Mark Odin, saying thanks, back to Master Control.